Hello fellow 3D artists. We are always working on getting our renderings more photographic and photorealistic, and one way to do that is to use depth of field and get a really nice camera-like bokeh into your renderings. I have a tutorial on how to do this in V-Ray. In Blender there is no implemented feature to use your own aperture texture maps. And so I'm showing you how to do it in a kind of old-fashioned way, and that's you are actually shooting through a lens. Now, for this, we're not going to use a real modeled lens. It's just a plane with a texture on it. As an important note, this is going to make your rendering slower, but this is with any depth of field effect in any rendering software. So let's begin. When you get the custom aperture maps from my stores, I also have a free sample, by the way, which you can check out. You will get a custom aperture camera rig file. And you just open it up and I will show you what it consists of. And that is the bokeh camera, which is a basic, normal Blender camera, which is in the center of the scene. And just in front of that, we have the custom aperture plate, which is the plane with the texture mapped on it, as you can see here in the object shader. And we're going to shoot through that. You already see that depending on the aperture map, your scene is going to get darker because you're actually shooting through something and it's going to swallow some light. So you would have to go into your scene camera settings and adjust the exposure as you need. Everything is linked together. So if you're going to move your camera, the custom aperture map and the focal point are going to move together. And so you don't have to worry about anything anymore. You just use it as your normal Blender camera. Saying that, you can change the focal length to whatever you need and you can adjust the f-stop. So the f-stop is going to determine how strong our bokeh effect is. So I would recommend not going lower than 0.6. So if you're shooting through 0.2 or something like that, the aperture plate is going to come through and it's going to look strange. And you're already shooting through a real expensive prime lens there if you're at 0.6. So if you want to keep it to real life data, you don't need to go lower than that. To change the texture file, you just choose the custom aperture map. We are in shading mode here right now, and you go to the object, you load in a different aperture map. So I have a few here, which I'm selling on Blender Market, Gumroad, and ArtStation. You just go ahead and make your own. It's really fun to create your own aperture maps. And you choose whatever you wish. Easy peasy and beautiful. You can have fake chromatic aberration in there, which is called CA at the end. So let's take a strong one, something like this. We're going to have some kind of chromatic aberration in the depth of field, which is not real chromatic aberration, it's just in your bokeh shape. What else do you have? You have a focal point. So the focal point is here, this is the cross, it's the object. And you just put the focal point object to wherever you want your focus to be. And that's it. Or if you like, you switch off the focal point and you set it by yourself. This is one way for getting bokeh into your renderings with Blender. And I hope sometimes in the future there will be such feature that you can just put in the texture maps into your Blender camera and it's all easy peasy. So if you have any questions about the setup, about my custom aperture maps, just ping me at shine@addyourlight.com or whatever marketplace you are, and I'm glad to be of service. For more Blender tutorials and other videos in the future, please like and subscribe. It means the world to me. Thanks for watching. You take care.